Right now, there is a very high chance that microscopic eight-legged animals are living, eating, and also dying inside the pores of your skin. They're called Demodex face mites. You weren't born with them. You likely picked them up from your parents through skin contact as a child. And every night, while you sleep, those creatures crawl out to mate on the surface of your skin. Let's have a closer look. While the thought of them can be uncomfortable, they are a natural part of our human ecosystem. I found several specimens on my own forehead and also inside the hair follicles of my eyelashes. To find them, I carefully pulled on my eyelashes and rotated them to squeeze the mites out of the follicles. I then collected them using some clear adhesive tape. Face mites are not spiders, they are related to them. Like spiders, they have eight legs. Occasionally, you might find a specimen with only six legs, and these are the larvae. And they will then shed their skin as they grow, and eventually they will transform into an adult with eight legs. They are about one third of a millimeter long, and their body shape is long and slender. This allows them to fit into the hair follicles of our eyebrows and eyelashes. The hair follicles are the parts of the skin where hair grows. And the face mites were discovered in the 19th century. These drawings show different kinds and also how several individuals can live together inside a single follicle. Face mites are nocturnal, and this means that they come out at night. They mate on the surface of our skin, and then they produce eggs and the life cycle repeats. So far, 65 different species have been identified. Many of them live on hosts other than humans. Face mites feed on the oil that our skin produces. They are unique because while they digest their food, they do not have an anus. So they store all of their wastes inside of their bodies. And when they die, they release these wastes into the skin again, and our body then has to clean up the area. In most cases, Demodex face mites are completely harmless and are a natural component of healthy skin. However, they can cause problems if they multiply too much. There are possible connections to acne and also rosacea, which is a reddening of the skin. Face mites carry a bacterium called Bacillus olearonius, and some studies suggest the immune system reacts to these bacteria, which may add to the redness and inflammation in the rosacea. Now, I hope that you found this investigation interesting. I'm Oliver, and I wish you happy microbe hunting. And as always, see you in the next video. Bye-bye.